Hello friends, in this video we will discuss sliding friction force and rolling friction force. Please make sure you watch different types of forces part 1 to part 6, then go ahead with part 7. Sliding friction force is the resistance created by any two objects when sliding against each other. This friction is also known as kinetic friction. So when two objects are sliding against each other, they are actually moving against each other. So sliding friction force is similar to the kinetic friction force. In the last video, we have discussed formula of kinetic friction force. We can use the same formula for sliding friction force also. This person pushes this box, and so box is moving to the right. So his pushing force would be towards right direction, and this box moves to the right direction with acceleration A. You know, friction always acts in opposite direction of object's motion. This box is sliding on this floor, so there is a sliding friction force. So we can represent it as FS. It will act towards left. So there are two forces acting on this box which is sliding right now. First is pushing force towards right, and second is sliding friction force towards left. So net force on this sliding box would be F push minus sliding friction. Now we will use Newton's second law, which says F net equals M times A. Here M is the mass of the box and A is the acceleration of the box. This box is moving with acceleration A. So just plug in values. So we will get F net equals F push minus F S equals M A. So this is the force equation. We can use this force equation to find sliding friction force. In some books, the same equation is given as applied force minus friction force equals M times A. So both equations are same. Next is rolling friction force. Rolling friction force is the resistance force that exists between a rolling object and the surface in contact. So rolling object like wheel, ball, or any round object. For example, wheels of the car. So here is the wheels. Wheels of the car are rolling on this road. If car is moving forward in this direction, then wheel will roll clockwise direction like this. You can see at this point this wheel is touching the surface of the road, and at this point you can see wheel motion is towards back. And you know, friction force always acts in opposite direction of object's motion. At this point wheel is rolling back to move the car forward. So direction of rolling friction would be forward. This way we can represent rolling friction as FR. So keep in mind, rolling friction always supports the car's motion. We can find the value of rolling friction force using the formula FR equals mu R times normal force. Like mu R is the coefficient of rolling friction, FN is the normal force. So basically we learned three types of coefficient of friction force. First was coefficient of static friction force. The second was coefficient of kinetic friction force or the sliding friction force. And third was coefficient of rolling friction force. So here is the relation between them. Coefficient of static friction force is the greatest. It is greater than coefficient of kinetic friction force, and coefficient of rolling friction is the least. So coefficient of rolling friction force is generally much smaller than the coefficient of sliding friction and coefficient of static friction. I hope you understand this topic so far. In the next video, we will discuss tension forces along the ropes and strings. So stay tuned and study more. Don't forget to subscribe, share and likes for daily updates. Thank you for watching.